Hello and welcome to the Greasy Bench. Today I'm going to review the helmet I've been using for the past year. It's a Bell Super. I have no affiliation with Bell. I just got this as a pro deal from the bike shop I work with. And I want to show you the Bell helmet I'm talking about is my Bell Super 2R helmet. This Super 2R helmet is special because it comes with a shin bar attachment already. And it's a pretty lightweight helmet. Have a lot of ventilation, so you feel pretty fresh. It also comes with a MIPS system that helps you against rotational impacts. I also chose this helmet for my older son since he started doing BMX, and that's one of the important features of rotational protection. This helmet also comes with a removable shin bar, so if it's a hot day or you're just doing casual riding, you can take the shin bar without the need of tools, and you can also adjust the visor up or down, or you can even remove it all the way you want to look like Nico Rogatkin. The helmet also came with a bracket for an action camera, but I don't like to wear the camera on the helmet because normally it produces some neck pain on me, so I prefer to wear a chest mount for that, but each their own. So before I used to have this helmet in particular, I used to ride with this guy. It's a Jimbo Phillips helmet. It's also a Bell. For some reason, I tend to gravitate to Bell helmets. This is in better years. But with Bell helmets, it's a matter of comfort. Normally, I feel some pressure points on the back of my head, like just there, with other helmets. But with Bell, normally I feel comfortable. So I normally buy the large to extra large helmets. I have a big head, so I like comfort too. So this helmet doesn't have the adjustability of the Super helmet. There's no strap, and you just play with the sponges to get it right. Not so light and particularly hot. There's not many vents on this helmet. It just looks awesome. Between these two helmets, I have this guy. This cranked helmet from Canadian Tire. It's a convertible helmet too, comes with a shin bar, and also comes with a visor that you can barely adjust. But anyway, it was there. You can remove it too if you feel like it. The helmet was like medium to large, so it felt a little bit kind of tight on me, but I still use it just to see if I like it, the convenience of having the removable shin bar. This shin bar, you need to remove it with tools, and I already replaced the screws because these screws were like so soft that the material just breaks on the first time you remove it. There's no adjustability, and you just make the best using these foam pads on the side to see if it fits the best on your face. I removed also a piece from the front because I was not able to breathe with this helmet. It was so tight on there that there was no air passing, and you can see that there is no ventilation whatsoever on this helmet. So now let's go back to the Super R helmet. Okay, then again, this helmet is really fresh. There's a lot of ventilation in the hot days, and it's rather convenient, but that's not the only thing. You can also, since you can adjust the back with the toggle back here, I can also wear this helmet in winter just wearing a toque underneath the helmet. So still warm, it's not perfect for a winter helmet, but still it's better than nothing if you want to do some mountain biking in winter. Now, let's talk about this shin bar. You can remove it by just flipping these switches on the side and the one on the back. No tools required. It's pretty light that you can carry on your backpack, and now you just got yourself a really nice half helmet. So you don't look like a total mountain biking geek around. These pins over here is just to hold the straps. So there's no metal pieces in this helmet like the other one I showed you that have the screws that go in. You don't want anything metal inside of the helmet in case you have a crash. You just want to have your head inside the helmet. So therefore, with the MIPS system, the adjustability, and all the pads that you can remove and wash them, or you can even order them online. So if you feel like getting one of these helmets, you can get the full package as I did. Or you can just get the top part, and later on, if you want it, you can buy the shin bar. Just make sure that you buy the right shin guard, because the shin bars are of different sizes, so you need to get the one for your helmet. Now, there's another little trick that I do and have to do with the visor. Yes, you can fit a GoPro down here, but let's be honest, cameras are heavy on the head. So what I do, especially when I go later to do my rides and I'm maybe going to be stranded, I put a headlamp. Why not? The headlamp feels nicely there, it's like properly located, and the best part of it is that I can pretty much just use it, and wherever I look, I see the light. This is a cheap light from a Walmart. I use it sometimes when I commute at night. So this is all I have to say. This is my Bell Super 2R helmet. If you like this review, please hit the like button, and if you want to see more content like this, just subscribe, and this is the Greasy Bench, a mini review of the Bell Super Helmet. Thanks for watching.